Now choirs and places where they sing, the fourth in our series of 11 weekly programmes introduced by John Betjeman. Today's programme comes from Southwell Minster, and we hear the Minster Choir and his rector cori, Kenneth Beard. Here is John Betjeman.
Southwell, I believe the people who were born here call it, but Southwell is how the BBC pronounces it. And of the Minster, now called Southwell Cathedral, someone said, "Other churches may be older, a few may be larger, but none is more beautiful." This is true. It has three qualities which distinguish it above all else: colour, carving, and peace. People think of Nottinghamshire as tips and mines and sudden rows of red brick streets, but it's also the county of Sherwood Forest and of this tree-embowered kingdom round the Minster, which until 1841 was known as the Soak of Southwell, with its own government, civil and ecclesiastical. The first thing you notice is the colour. The fields round the little town are of red earth, almost as red as Devon. The houses, school and chapels are of pale pink brick, and they're mostly Georgian and elegant. There can be few small towns so little spoiled as Southwell, and from wherever you are in its streets, you can see the country. The roofs of the houses have warm red crinkly tiles. Contrasting with and dominating the whole town and soak is the Minster, here in a hollow of the hills. It's of golden limestone from Bolsover. The stone has almost the quality of sunlight and seems to send a reflection out from itself onto the grass of the surrounding churchyard. The two Norman towers and the octagonal early 14th century chapter house are capped with spires of silvery lead. The colour of Southwell and its Minster is all in materials, in brick, stone, wood, grass, lead. There is no bright paint and not much stained glass. What remains in the memory is the texture, weathered but clean, of walls and old stone floors. And then there's the carving. Here's a place where the carvers enjoyed themselves. All along the eaves of the roof are carved heads with funny faces, toothache, laughter, weeping, yelling. On buttresses near the chapter house, there's a fine pair of porkers. Come in here at the west end. A stone screen divides the serene and simple nave and transepts. Round stumpy columns, round windows, round arches, from the choir. And this stone choir screen is a miniature vaulted cloister, encrusted with carved stone leaves and every sort of face you can imagine. But there's more to see. First, the stateliness of choir and transepts, and east end, and then turn to the north, a stone passage with carved capitals, just at eye level, leads to the exquisite stone arch to the chapter house. On this arch is a carving of leaves and people and animals, standing out strong and three-dimensional from the wall. Pigs eating acorns, a man blowing a hunting horn, a goat eating ivy leaves, lizards, owls, monks, churls, the whole medieval world of Sherwood Forest put into stone in about 1290. And the life spills on through the arch and over the carved walls of the chapter house itself. A great stone-vaulted octagon with no central pillar. It was here the chapter of the Minster met. It was here in the choir the prebends sat. And a college of Southwell somehow survived the Reformation and even Cromwell until 1841, when the ecclesiastical commissioners got hold of it. But they've kept it well and carefully ever since. Southwell is a place of peace. The Archbishop of York, from pre-conquest times, used it as his chief place of retreat, Cardinal Wolsey spent his last years here when he fell from power. Charles I gave up his struggle with a covenanting Scottish enemy here. The pleasant brick close east of the choir is where the provost and cathedral choir live. Before that, the vicar's choral lived here. Over the road are more Georgian houses connected with the ancient grammar school which supplies the choir. West of the cathedral is the Georgian building which used to house it. Everywhere around is an atmosphere of peace. And in the minster, there's one of prayer. Southwell has an abiding strength. And now let's listen to the choir. We hear first, O Nata Lux by Thomas Tallis. Now a motet by Tallis's famous pupil William Byrd, Justorum animae.
Thank you.
The organ here in Southwell Minster stands majestically on the screen. The most recent work on it was done by Hill, Norman and Beard in 1959. One of the things they did was to add the positive section, which can be heard to good effect in this Noël by the early French composer Nicolas Lebègue, which Kenneth Beard plays us now. It's called Une Vierge Pucelle. Now one of Maurice Greene's most widely known anthems, Lord, Let Me Know Mine End.
Thank you.
Kenneth Beard now plays us Rhapsody on a Ground by Heathcote Statham, who was organist of Norwich Cathedral until last Christmas.
Thank you.
now a short anthem by Robert Ashfield, who was organist here before moving to Rochester Cathedral a few years ago. There is a stream. We hear now the Magnificat in G major by Herbert Howells. end this programme, we hear My Beloved Spake by Patrick Hadley, who was Professor of Music at Cambridge until 1962.
That was the fourth in our series of 11 weekly programmes called Choirs and Places Where They Sing. Today you heard the choir of Southwell Minster under its rector, Corey Kenneth Beard. As usual, the programme was introduced by John Betjeman. Next week, the series features the choir of New College, Oxford, and the organist of the college, David Lumsden, with Walter Hilsman and Alistair Rose assistant organists. That's at 9:04 next Sunday morning.